crazy, you know, Latino doing Sinatra. You know, I haven't really seen anybody do Sinatra, really, you know, like he does. You know, now Latino from East LA, yeah, it's kind of crazy from Montebello, right? Yeah, so it's kind of weird, you know. So when people see him and open his mouth and start singing, and you just see everybody's face like light up. Like this morning, we had a group of people here. They were having their lunch here, and we did a sound check, and all their eyes just opened up. It's like, what's going on here? You know, how's that voice coming out of him? You know, yeah.
Let's get things going, and here we go. If you can use some exotic food, there's a bar for Bombay. Come on, fly with me, fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In lava land, there's a one man band and no two will do for you. Come on, fly with me. Let's float down the blue. Try catching warfare where the air is rarefied. We're gonna fly absolutely starry-eyed. Once I catch you warfare, I'll be holding you. Just because we're together, we're the wise and such a lovely day. Just say the word and I'll beat that bird down to our Pupo Bay. It's perfect for the flying honeymoon, they say. Come on, fly with me, we'll fly. Pack up your stuff, baby, let's get out of here and fly. Once I get you up there, where the air is so rarefied, we're gonna fly. Absolutely starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You might hear angels cheer just because we're together. We're the wise.
Hey, Miss Frank Barajas. I am actually the singer of The Wise Guys, but this is my solo show tonight. I grew up and my whole life was in East LA, Montebello. First couple years was in East LA, then moved to Montebello. Pretty much my whole life was in Montebello. 2 years when I was a kid, I lived in Mazatlan, Sinaloa, Mexico. Music, the way I learned this kind of music, big band music, Sinatra music, was pretty much from my father. He listened to everything, so I can go. I know your cumbias, I know your norteñas, I know banda, I know. But Sinatra was one of the things that he, you know, a lot of people were like, well, why would he like that? But it's just big, you know, big band music, and we come from a long line of musicians. And as we grew up, you know, there's nothing more romantic than Sinatra, you know, so you want to impress a girl, you kind of want to play that kind of music, give you a little bit of class. And there's no worse songs about heartbreak than the songs that Sinatra sings as well. So if you got your heart broken, you know that. And of course, if you watch Goodfellas, Bronx Tale, Casino, all these wonderful movies by Scorsese, you recognize these songs. So tonight we're doing our Christmas edition of the place, of the Sinatra Sundays, which is what I call this little program.
I simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Hey, the answer is no.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Sister,
how lucky you dropped in. Look out the window, it's gone.
My sister will be so.
Oh, your answer to the shores.
My brother will be there.
Bring on up a lot of the shore.
Really,
there's no one to the door.
So it's been going good, man. We're getting young, old, a lot of women, a lot of guys, marrying singles. It's been a good crowd, and actually tonight it's sold out. You know, it's reserved out, as you can say. I'm not sold out, but reserved out. And we're expecting a really good crowd, so we'll see how it goes. So for being the day before Christmas Eve, it's a pretty good sign, you know, we're doing pretty well. So I'm excited, I'm happy, and it's been great, man. It's a lot of love from the people, a lot of respect, and I totally dig it, man. Just make sure that the people are entertained, first and foremost, you know, that's how you rehearse, man, you know, kind of like where you want to rehearse, to make sure that you give them a good show. You can't dwell on it too much, because then you go nuts, you know. So it's just enjoy the moment, and thank God that you got the opportunity. And in regards to my voice, I don't know where it comes about, but it's there, so I might as well use it while I got a chance, and make the best of it.
So here we go, for all you guys, for all you lovers out there, for all you dance birds, this is a song that I really enjoy doing. It goes something like this. Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just singing of you. And the way you look tonight, we got the birthday girl. Yes, your lovely.
Oh man, music in a few words. I don't have a few words, I have a lot of words for music. Music is the one that keeps me going, you know. When I'm happy, that's what I need to have. When I'm sad, it's what I need to have. I play it constantly around my son, because I always had that for my parents, my father especially, and I have nothing but great memories with music, because music will take you back to that happy time, you know, or that sad time, but there takes you back to that sad time where you were at, where look where you're at now, kind of a thing. And I always kind of like to look at the positive, so we all go through crap, you know. So I always kind of remind myself, like, if I listen to that song, I was feeling so low, so back then, but look where I'm at now, you know, when it comes back again. So always compare where you're at, and music has helped me do that 100%. So I honestly think if it wasn't for music, I'd probably be a piece of shit somewhere, I don't know. Music saved me a lot. It's how I can honestly say, and it's kept my family, myself, example for my brother, kept us real close. You know, we always talk about family, but when it comes to, when we can sit down, we can just talk music for hours. And I wouldn't change that for the world, you know? So that's what music, I mean, music is everything for me. I can't live without it. I like to interact with the people, because I don't just want them to just go and sit there and just be like, oh, that was whatever. Because a lot of times, the best stories or the best moments come when you talk to the people in the audience. And at the same time, I want them to be a part of it. I want them to feel like, hey, man, I know that guy. And after the show, I talk to them. You know, man, well, they're not, you know, no one, it's not a beauty contest. You know, I'm not there to be stared at, kind of a thing. As Sinatra would say, you know, I like to talk to the people to see how they're feeling. You know, hey, it's someone's birthday, well, just enjoy a little bit more. Have yourself a drink, man. You know, hey, if the people are sitting next to you, make sure that they cheer you. You know, like, hey, man, it's your birthday. It's your anniversary, whatever. And maybe they'll come back again. But like, you know what, I had a good time. Not only did he sing, but he also told stories, he entertained, and you know, and that's what I want. That's what I want to show. I think a lot of people now sing, and they have great voices and all, but that's all they do. You know, oh, you hear me sing, you know. So maybe I'm more grateful that they're there. So I want to, you know, include them in the show and make them part of the show. So like I said, I think I even told you the story in high school. You know, when I tried out for choir, the teachers kicked me out. You know, she's like, don't come back later. And I was like, all right. And that was probably, you know, a blessing, because I probably would have ended up hating it from a teacher like her, right? So it's part of life, you know. I just learned it as it went along. How long do I plan to keep on singing? As long as I have a voice and I remember the lyrics and people are there to listen and go like, yeah, keep on doing it, I'm going to do it. Because there comes a time, you know, when you're already old, and I've seen it at bars, I've seen it in bands where, you know, you don't belong up there anymore, you know. And I respect the music that much where I'm like, I'm not going to make an ass of myself or ass of the music. So if, as long as I could do it and give my 100% and honor the music, I'm going to keep on doing it. But just to do it, just because my money's there or whatever like that, I don't see myself doing that, because I've seen a lot of people be on stage when they shouldn't be anymore. And I think it messes up whatever good that they had, you know. I'd rather be remembered for, man, that kid was good when, you know, when he used to sing Sinatra. Why doesn't sing anymore? Because I sound like shit, you know. I'd rather you remember me in a good way you know, then, man, I went to go see him, and that guy, you know, was drunk, couldn't sing for shit. And it's happened. I'm sure you guys, you know, how many times have you gone to shows and you see that? So as long as I could do it, if I'm healthy, God willing, I'll keep on doing it. But when the time comes, then... But it's not just going to be because, like, oh, you know, my wife says I don't kiss. Like, sorry, woman, you married into this. It's going to be more so on my own terms when I'm done. When I feel my voice is done, and that's it.
Once again, thank you all. We have a full house tonight. Has everyone been seated all right? You guys waiting for... It was crazy, man. I came in earlier, and everything was reserved. So it feels pretty nice, man. I hope you guys enjoy the music. And I thank you guys for spending that evening with us tonight. So, that being said, I'm going to continue on with the music, and here we go.
I've got the world on a string, sitting on the rainbow, got the string around my finger. What a world, what a life I love. I've got a song that I sing, I can make the rain go. Anytime I hold my finger, look at me, can't you see I'm in love? Life's a beautiful thing, as long as I hold the string. Happy, silly, so and so, if I should ever let it go. I've got the world on a string, sent on a rainbow. Got the string around my fingers. What a world, what a life, I'm in love. Life's a beautiful thing, as long as I hold the string. I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let it go. I've got the world on a string, sent on a rainbow. Got the string around my fingers. What world? Man, this is a life.
Thank you for the tips right here, ladies and gentlemen. Christmas is tomorrow, and I'm trying to buy my son a toy.